Hi, and welcome to Morning Mayan. Today I'm going to talk about how to make a wish come true, or how to manifest your dream, or how to create what you would like in your life. It's another way of saying that. I tried to download a video, it didn't pick up very well. I taught this course for a long time, many years, at the Learning Annex and based off my book. I'd like to just freelance it and give it to you now, because in these times I'd like to give us all some hope and some bright times, and also remind us that we're very, very powerful and magical beings, and we are creating our life, and we are filled with the divine spirit. So let's get to it, shall we? Okay, I'm assuming that a bunch of you that may be tuning into this have already had a basic knowledge about The Secret, or know about The Secret. When I was lecturing on my book and my information on the Mayans originally, and frequency attunement, people would come to my lectures and say, have you ever heard of the Hicks or Abraham, which I never had. And then they would go on to tell me about their channelings and speaking about the law of affinity and the law of attraction, or what's been known now as The Secret. And I was just really happy that we were all channeling the same divine information. That made me feel like we were all on the same page. So after doing lots of lectures and working with people, you start to realize that taking the ideas that come with The Secret or the law of attraction and actually pulling them down into a reality that you can work with are two different things. So today I want to take you through some easy lessons on how to make your wishes come true. Okay, the number one thing that you have to do when you want to make a wish is make sure that you're in a high frequency. Now, I've talked about this in other lectures before, but basically, you know you're in a high frequency when you're really in a happy place, you feel very connected, when you're in nature, or when you're laughing is a really good time. So, since the number one thing to going to make a wish is that you want to send it out in the highest frequency possible, is that you want to get in the highest frequency possible to put that out. So, you can do that one of two ways. Either you can wait until you're in an authentically really good place. I can think about a time I was in Big Sur, and I was on this big swing, and I was swinging out over the trees and into like this beautiful valley overlooking the ocean, and I was just like so giddy and happy, and I thought to myself, this is make-a-wish time, this is make-a-wish time. So I say to you, if you find yourself in a really happy, ecstatic place, let that ring in your head right time. This is make-a-wish time, and take that time when you're in that high frequency to send out and use this information I'm about to give you. So, and then there's times when you don't want to sit around and wait for yourself to be in a high frequency or find that high frequency, and you want to stimulate that in yourself. So there's many ways to do that. Dancing, singing, going out in nature, I would say, is the number one way to reconnect yourself to high frequency. Sometimes getting in a bath and just getting calm and peaceful will put you in that place. But I found that one of the surefire ways of getting in a high frequency is to rent a comedy and watch the comedy. And when you're laughing, you're in a high frequency. So when you find yourself laughing during the movie, you can stop, excuse yourself, and go do this little wish exercise. Because when you're in that high frequency, that's when I want to send out the wishes. Because when you're in a low frequency and you go to send out something, what you're doing is you're also sending out your fears and your blocks and your worries. And that, by the very vibration of it, will not allow you to bring in that what you wish. So the number one thing is get in a high frequency. Okay, number two is really figure out what it is you want. And you know, most people think, oh, I want this, and when I'm in lectures with people, you know, I'll use this one girl for instance, you know, she's like, oh, there's this guy in the office and I love him and I want him to marry me. And I said, oh, okay, really? Okay, how much do you know about this guy? Well, she didn't know a whole lot about him. She'd never been out with him. She really didn't know anything about it, so she was attracted to him. So what I say is, because in the third dimension, we manifest in a triangle, mind, body, spirit. Now you have to know that if you're in all agreement, you may have found this before with somebody you were dating, that maybe your body was really attracted to them. You had great sex, or you had this great intimacy. And maybe even your spirit was connected to them, and you felt like, you know, you had the same kind of passions in life and same drive and destiny. But somehow your minds weren't syncing up. Well, somewhere along the line, if not all three parts of you line up, mind, body, spirit, you're not going to make that happen in your life. So what I'm saying is, when you go to manifest something in your life, you need to realize that you're working with three parts of yourself, three little judges, if you will, of our own little congressional system and balancing act. But in our case, it's the mind, the body, and the spirit. And if you don't realize that they each have a voice, then you won't pay attention to what each one of them are saying. And the fact is, you won't manifest anything or pull it into the third dimension, because you need to use six-dimensional geometry to do that, unless you have a true connection. A triangle actually forms a solid geometry so it can manifest, okay? So what I said to this girl was, let's downscale your wish. You don't even know this guy. What is something, where's a first step? Where's a first step toward this wish that you want? And so she said, okay, I don't really know the guy I'm attracted to. I guess like him asking me out for coffee would be a really nice step for me to get to know him. So one of the really important things, besides getting in a high frequency, which is number one, the second thing is actually getting a workable wish and getting something that you can all deal with. You see, all three parts of her weren't ready to get married to this guy that she didn't know. It makes no logical sense. Even if her spirit and her body were like, ugh, let's go, her mind was like, I don't know this guy. So by scaling down the wish to something that was simple, like a date, a cup of coffee, she didn't get any blocks. Her mind's like, I can deal with a cup of coffee, getting to know somebody, that makes sense. Her spirit was already engaged, and obviously she was already physically attracted to him. So the second thing is, scale down your wish to something that you really feel comfortable with, and then build from there. Maybe you want to be the CEO of your company, but the truth is, you're not ready to skyrocket from the mailroom to CEO. Maybe you just want a promotion to start out with, and then build and go from there. So the second secret to creating and manifesting your wish is to scale down your wishes into steps that all of you are in agreement in, so you don't have any blocks. Because when you send something out on a high frequency, it's going to come in by the law of attraction. And because that's what happens in high frequency, things come to you. Unless you have a block, like I said, that'll come from the mind, body, or spirit. So if you block something, then it won't come in. And you think, oh, I'm doing something wrong, or this doesn't work, or it's all baloney. Instead of realizing that you're blocking it, and then going back and finding out where you're blocking it. So the best way I found in my lectures and working with people is to scale down your wish to something smaller so that all of you is in agreement with. Okay?